Are you ready?
Ready. Go!
Come here. Come here, lay down here. Come on, Nero, you. Come on. Here, here. Ah, there, come on. Gina? Gina, come here. Lie down there. There.
Master.
What happened?
Marquis.
I want that lioness.
What's the name again?
Caprice.
I would like to shake hands with Caprice. Put her in the practice cage.
Bad time now, Nikita. She's about to be fed.
Well, so much the better. She will show more life, more fire. Put her in a cage.
All right. On your own risk.
All right.
Boys, come on.
Master. Wait at least until she has been fed.
Put in the practice cage. Go and watch monkeys.
Caprice, huh? He is beautiful. Caprice! Now, get me a chair.
Nikita, you know what you're doing.
Sure I do. Open the door.
Who is she?
Marshall's daughter.
Poor kid. Don't be afraid, darling. She wouldn't do anything to me.
You must go now, Lida, and let Madame finish your pack.
I don't want to go to an orphan. I told you yesterday, Papa Roma. I don't want to go. I don't want to go.
Marshall can leave us soon.
Well, orphanage is not the place for Marshall's daughter. Huh? You don't want to go to an orphanage, do you?
Never, sir.
Would you rather go with me to Paris?
Yes,
sir. Well, go and pack your things.
But, master...
Shut up!
Thank you. You don't want them.
Goodbye, Rambo. I'll take good care of them. Don't worry.
Bye.
Au revoir.
Bye.
Lida, I brought you your milk.
What's the matter? You're crying? Look, I brought you your milk.
No. You must be a brave little girl. Remember, your father used to be a performer.
Daddy? My poor daddy.
It's very late. But I'll take care of you. I'll take care of you as long as I live. That's going to be a long time. I will try to be a father to you. I cannot do more. No, don't go. Don't go.
Now have some milk. That's a good one. That's a
Oh, please don't take him.
No, no, no. It's not a time to play. Time to sleep. Good night. Well, Lida, now I'm going into the arena to do my act. You'll wait for me right here under this flag.
Yes, monsieur.
Then when I come back, I'll know where to find you. And don't talk to anybody. If somebody will be talking to you, just answer for that.
Nikita did a grand thing. He's got a good heart, all right.
How's Caprice?
All right.
Now remember what I told you. Don't move from here. I'll be exactly 18 minutes.
Yes, monsieur.
Tonight I will present for your entertainment one of the most staggering, one of the most sensational events in the history of animal training. How fresh in your memories must be the tragedy of last Wednesday night at the Circus Rambo, where that magnificent Nubian lioness, Caprice, attacked and killed her keeper. This would be Caprice's first appearance since that gruesome tragedy. Now then, ladies and gentlemen, tonight in my own circus, our own Nikita, the fearless, will enter the cage and break down the spirit of this ferocious queen of the beasts. Ladies and gentlemen, Caprice.
on your face. Too smart for the poor Marco. Now you've met your match.
Still the same. Don't you ever smile? Of course, you're coming to my party tonight.
I'm sorry, but I can't come.
But why not? I've arranged it specially for you. Don't you ever get tired of standing under this old clock? You know, one of these nights I'm going to come along and put a bomb inside it and blow it to pieces. Then where will Nikita put you?
You to mix up with them.
Did you hear that?
Yes, he makes me sick.
Nikita, huh? I'd like to speak with you for a moment.
All right.
Alone.
Alone?
Yeah, just for a moment.
All right, Lida, wait for me here.
Lida.
Why do you want to see me alone?
Well, we needn't know our private business.
All right, sure.
Well, I hardly know how to explain. Like this, Nikita. What we need in this circus is an attraction that appeals to women.
What do you mean? Don't I appeal to women?
Oh, of course you do. You don't understand. But you appeal to the gallery, to the men. What we really need is a matinee idol.
You talk about Trelawney, huh?
Yeah.
A cheap magician who pulls rabbits out of the hat. Where has he ever headlined? Outside of a tent show.
Never mind, he packs them in. The women adore him. If I can play him here, Lady Pilcott will buy a box for the season. Whatever that woman does, every woman in her set follows it.
Now listen, Corn. Let's understand one another. I am not headlining with Trelawney.
I've got a contract with him.
Well, then cancel it. All right, please. There is going to be only one star in this circus, and that is Nikita. Keep that in your mind.
Oh, come on now, let's go. Everybody's waiting for
us. No,
her.
I'll come.
Oh, now, please.
Now, listen, young man. I don't want you to talk to Lida anymore. Keep away from her.
Why should I? Because I tell you to.
You talk like a husband. She's not your wife.
Yeah, what's the matter with you? You're afraid to get out of here.
Stop, you. Go on, about the business. Later.
I want you to fire him.
Fire him? You're crazy. If I fired every man around the circus in love with Lida, I wouldn't have any circus left.
It's about time that you realize that Lida's a grown-up woman. Only natural that men should run after her.
Well, I think Papa Cohen is right. You don't realize Lida is a pretty girl now.
So you really think she's very pretty, eh?
Who's there?
It's me.
It's Granny.
Lida, I want to talk to you something very important. It's about that young gaucho that was annoying you.
He wasn't annoying me.
Well, all right, he wasn't annoying you, but he was talking to you, wasn't he? Do you like him?
No. He doesn't mean anything to me. But he's a nice boy. And I'm sorry you hit him.
Well, perhaps I was a little bit too rough with him, but... You see, you've been with me all these years, and I've got always to protect you. Especially now. You're not a child any longer. That's what they say. You're a young, beautiful woman. They say that too. And they are right. They are right. You see, I've never noticed all these things before, but I'm noticing them now. And I don't want anyone to take you away from me.
Well, who would take me away from you?
Well, you want to get married, don't you?
Married? I never thought of it.
Well, neither did I. But supposing it happens, what should I do then?
I cannot imagine this house without you. Only two plates at the table instead of three. Coming into this room and not to find you. Is there anyone else you like besides the boy I hit?
No. I mean only you and Pietro.
No? Would you like to marry Pietro?
No, of course not.
How would you like to marry me?
You?
Yes, yes, well, I knew it would be a surprise for you. But I've decided it's the best thing for me and the best thing for you. I can't let you go, Lida. I will make you happy, I know. Why do you keep quiet?
I don't know what to say.
Well, I've always been nice to you, haven't I? And I will be even nicer after I am your husband. Yes, yes, but nothing will change. You'll be the mistress of this house and you'll have everything you want. I can't let you go, Lida. I'll make you happy, I know. You've never been unhappy all these years you've been here, have you?
No. I'm very, very grateful to you.
Well, then it's settled. Lida. Lida. Well, that's all I wanted to find out. Lida. You're tired.
Yeah. You go to bed. You go to bed like a nice little girl.
Peter, you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Lida, you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband?
My dear children of the circus world, for after all, we are one great family. And I'm proud to be known to you as Father Corn. Many of you here tonight, now world famous, started your careers under me, and I love you all as a father. My friends, we are congregated here tonight to celebrate the wedding of two of the most beloved of our family, Nikita the Fearless and Lida the Lovely.
No.
It is the climax of a glorious romance.
Come on, Mark. Just a few words.
Come on.
My dear friends, I really have never in my life spoken before so many people. I feel much more at home with my whip in my hand. The greatest pleasure an artist can have is to take a bow after he's done.
Yes.
And that's the way I feel now. Even much more so when I look at my dear, beautiful wife, Lida. And when I realize that from now on, I have full right to protect her. And there is no power in the whole world that can take that right away from me. Even Papa Corn. Wait a minute. And my friends, I am drinking this toast to my beautiful wife, Lida, and to a long life with... What's he doing there?
I'm here to congratulate you.
I don't want his congratulations.
Now, just a moment, please. Just a moment. Alex.
It's awful to be so late.
So good of you to come. Good evening.
How are you?
Lord and Lady Philcott, may I present my great family of artists. Of course, most of you know Trelawney. Peter, you know Trelawney.
Yes, I know Trelawney. What about that promise you made me?
Excuse me. Come on, outside, we'll talk
about it. Wait a minute. You, wait for me here.
Now, really, that's quite true. Thank
you. So lovely that I'd love to dance with you. Will you?
Oh, no, thank you. My husband told me to wait here.
Oh, don't be so silly. You must train your husband the way he should go.
Please. Come on. Beautifully you dance.
And I won't stand for it.
Wait a minute. Here. Come here. Tom, listen to me. Now, what difference can Trelawney, a magician, make to a lion tamer like me?
You look lovely in that wedding dress. Until this moment, I didn't know what envy was. I envy Nikita. What a lucky man he is. And you're to be envied too, you know.
Why?
Isn't love the most wonderful thing in the world? Why did you run away? Have I said something to offend you? I'll never forgive myself if I have. Tonight of all nights.
Monsieur Trelawney, it's nothing you have said.
But you're crying.
You are the only one who has seen it. I don't want anyone to know. Please forget.
On my word of honor, I'll never mention it to a soul.
Thank you.
Everyone started, huh?
Absolutely, that is definitely so.
When I come back, it won't make any difference.
Definitely not.
Where is Lida?
Where is she?
You are a clever magician.
Why?
Making beautiful young women disappear. It's a happy bride, too.
I was only showing you one of my tricks.
Well, you don't want to show me one of your tricks, will you?
Here you are. Where have you been?
Shy little bride, waiting for her husband under the cloud, eh?
Let's go home. Let's give everybody the sleep, huh? Two I love best. You. Tell him I want to see him just as soon as I come back. I'll get that dressing room by tomorrow. You'll see.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm so glad you're back.
Yes?
Safe under the clock again?
How did you know?
I asked about you. I wanted to find out everything about you I possibly could.
Why?
Because I've been thinking about you far more than's been good for my peace of mind. Do you wish me luck?
Of course.
Hey, Trelawney, what hour was the way you took my dressing room?
Mr. Korn gave me the dressing room. You better see him about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the great Trelawney.
They're the exact duplicates of those used on Devil's Island for dangerous criminals. I invite any lady or gentleman in the audience to come down and fetter me with these chains. And if it's a lady, I'd prefer a blonde.
Ah, so the bullet's outside. Well, come on down.
On the neck. And you lucky. All I need is a dog kennel and some biscuits, saying I'm all right.
Now this one here.
Set round the body.
See?
Now pull it tight, both of you. Come on, you strong boys. Come on, take the end of it.
Come on, don't get...
That's all right. Now help me up on the horse. Come on.
Push it, push it. Push it.
Now, listen, Korn. You've double-crossed him. You gave Trelawney my dressing room.
Now, this is no time or place to discuss these matters. I'll talk this over with you tomorrow.
You'll talk over this with me today. One room back. My dressing room.
All right, I'll speak to Trelawney about it.
What do you mean you speak to Trelawney about it? The dressing room belongs to me.
Trelawney's a star. He's entitled to the star dressing room.
That's just it. You have made him the star. You had no right to do it. You gave me your word.
I must look after my business.
Ah, don't worry about your business. Now that I'm back, we'll be packing them to the dogs. You don't have to have Trelawney any longer. Kick him out.
Oh, take it easy. Take it easy. Sit down. You listen to me. I'm going to be quite frank with you. When I engaged Trelawney, I didn't tell you the real reason.
What was the real reason?
Well, I didn't want to spoil your wedding and your honeymoon trip.
What was the real reason?
Business is bad. Very bad. And it got worse at every performance.
It was the weather.
It wasn't the weather, it was you.
What? Me?
Now, we're not going to mince matters any further. Your name on the bill doesn't draw them in more. Why, say, you've been doing the same old trick for 8 years. Public's fired us. You've got to brush up your act. While you were away, not one person fired at the box office when you were coming back. Not one.
Shh. Don't talk loud. I don't want my wife to hear it.
Well, it's tough to tell you this, old man, but there it is.
So they don't want me anymore, huh? They are tired of my old tricks.
Well, life's like that.
They want something new. Listen, Korn. Years ago, when I was a young fella, I always dreamt of doing something new with the lion. Some new trick that had never been done before. You know what I'm going to do?
What?
You see, the lion is always afraid of a man's eyes.
Yes, I know about that.
But more than this, he's afraid of a man's hands. You know what I'm going to do? I will walk into the cage with Caprice without my hands. My hands will be tied behind my back. Handcuffed! Huh?
Oh, well, if you do a trick like that...
I'll do the trick. I'll do it. I'll get my dressing room.
What do you care about a dressing room if you can do a trick like that?
That isn't the
innocent woman. It's Lida.
The priest, the stubborn beast, she sprang at me again.
You must be patient, Peter. You might get it tomorrow.
I'll get it tomorrow. I'll get it.
Master, I've been with you for a long time, haven't I?
Yeah?
I've never asked you to do me a favor.
But you're our one now. What is it?
Master, please, don't do that new trick with the priest.
What?
Don't do it. I know Papa Corn told you to go ahead. Well, he's not risking his life. He doesn't know what we both know. That the trick is impossible.
So you don't think I can do it, eh?
Of course, you can. You can do anything. But don't do it. I beg of you. But you promised me not to be angry.
I'm sorry.
Nikita, Pietro is right.
He's always right. He says it's impossible to do the trick.
I'm going to do it.
Attention, Caprice. Là, là.
Look.
C'est très bien.
He's got it.
Joli. Joli. Back. Back, Caprice. To your cage. To your cage.
All right. Lida, did you see it? Pietro, where is Cor?
All right, Lida, you go home. I'll see you later. I've got to find Cor. Oh, Cor! I've got the trick.
What trick?
I ran Hank up to my cage with Caprice, and she did everything I told her. Yes.
Well, I congratulate you. I never thought you'd do it.
I know it, but I told you I would. Now we can include the trick in our program.
Wait a minute now, wait a minute. Stallone is still packing them in. We don't want to include your act with his wonderful act.
Oh, forget about Trelawney. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll introduce your act on the night Trelawney closes. But I'm ready to do it now, tonight.
You'll do it on the night he closes. Understand? Besides, I've got to see your act first. Get that into your head.
Nikita.
How do you feel?
Oh, fine. I brought you a little wedding present.
Oh. It's nice. But it's too good. Oh, you're crazy. Take it back.
Oh, please. Look.
Very interesting. How do you like it, Lida?
Lovely.
Master, you'll be late.
Thanks, old man. Thanks. Lida. Put it in the dressing room.
See you later.
Thank you, Ivan. Hello.
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 What you got there?
Present.
Oh, what a nice little clock. Didn't I hear it chiming just now?
Yes. Where are you taking it?
To church today.
Who's Jack?
One of my doves. Look, they're in there. Jack and Jill.
You met Jack at your wedding party. Wouldn't you like to go in and meet Jill?
No, I mustn't.
Now, what difference could 8 little steps make in your life? Come on. And here we are.
Oh, how sweet.
Jill, I want you to meet Lida, an obedient little wife just like you are.
How do you do?
You see, when Jack does his act in the arena, Jill waits for him under that lump of sugar.
Tell me, Jack, does she never fly away?
She's never been tempted. Your eyes are beautiful when you smile like that.
To go.
No, not yet. We must celebrate your first visit to my dressing room.
How about I've been here before?
But not while I've been in it. And here's hoping it won't be the last.
I must go.
Oh, no, just a minute. I want to show you my magic blackboard.
Is it something new?
Yes. And you're going to be the first person who's going to see it. That's a great honor, you know. Now, you stay here and imagine that I'm the headmaster and you're the pupil. Now, attention in class, please. Watch the blackboard.
That's wonderful.
Look again.
Why don't you get dressed, Nikita? You've been through for 15 minutes, you know. Get dressed and let's go home.
The warning has finished.
Who is it? Come in.
Trelawney, I want to talk to you about your entrance music.
Yes?
It starts much too soon. Tonight I could have taken 2 more calls, but the orchestra started.
My dear fellow, I'll attend to it at once. I had no idea. I'm terribly sorry.
It's been going for the whole week.
I'll see to it right away, I promise you.
Well, see that it doesn't happen again.
How did that clock get here?
I found it. Why, is it yours?
Where did you find it?
On the drum at the bottom of the stairs. Just now, when I came out from my act.
Lida! Lida!
Come in here. How did that clock get here?
I don't know.
Where did you leave it?
I left it downstairs on the drum.
Don't leave things downstairs on a drum anymore.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Is everything all right? Does Nikita suspect anything?
No. But you must be careful. If he knew about yesterday, he'd kill you. You shouldn't be talking to me here.
But I must talk to you. Lida, I know now you mean more to me than anything in the world.
Do you mean that?
From the depths of my heart. Dearest, I'm longing to hold you in my arms again.
That can never happen.
Lida, don't say that. Please don't.
I'm afraid. Afraid for you.
See what the papers will say tomorrow. There are 3 photographers out front waiting for me. For me! Not for Trelawney. Trelawney. Magician and a horse. Wait till they see the real act. Did you see Papa Korn?
Yes, he's very busy in the box office.
How's the house?
Sold out.
You see? And you both wanted to stop me. How's Caprice?
When I fed her tonight, she was very quiet.
That's a good sign. How does it look?
Fine.
Well?
You better not, Nikita.
Why not? There is nothing wrong with one. Here is to Caprice.
Good luck.
Fortuna. Grazie, grazie.
Peter, are you nervous?
Nervous? Why? Everything is great, isn't it?
I'll tell them. Come on, let's go.
Pietro, I don't need you for the beginning of the act. Go and watch Caprice.
Yes, ma'am. Nikita, I see before.
Спасибо, спасибо, дорогой.
Good luck, my boy.
Thank you, Papa.
Last night here.
Please be careful.
I've got to see you alone. I must.
But it's impossible.
There's no such word as impossible when two people love each other.
You mustn't stay here. Pietro suspects us. I know he does.
I don't care who suspects. I'll wait for you upstairs.
Goodbye.
Just a few minutes. Please.
No, I'm afraid Nikita might find out.
But we've 18 minutes, an eternity. 18 minutes for me to look at you and listen to your voice.
Quiet, 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 quiet. Quiet, please. What is it?
I think Nikita must be crazy to go handcuffed in a cage with her.
Lida, I fell in love with you the first time I saw you, the first time I kissed you. Do you remember? Well, why did I let you go away from me then?
Don't talk about it now.
But Lida, I can't live without you. Come away with me. Don't think about anything. Just think how happy you're going to be with me.
No. We'll never see each other again.
But you love me. I know you do. I want to hear you say it. Tell me. Tell me you love me. Tell me.
Yes.
Have you seen Lida? Jack, have you seen Lida?
Yeah.
Oh, please, fetch her. Tell her to come here.
Oh, you fetch her. I'm no killjoy.
What do you mean?
Ladies and gentlemen, and now will follow the sensation of sensation. Our own Nikita will enter the cage of caprice, unattended, unprotected by spear or pistol, manacled. Nikita!
Master.
Please, don't do it tonight.
Oh, you're crazy.
I beg of you, don't do it.
Shut up!
Pick it up.
The handcuffs.
Master, you mustn't.
Get on with your job, the handcuff.
Master, you mustn't go on.
Shut up.
Master. Your wife is in Polonia's room.
What?
It's true.
Yourself and ruin me? They're tearing up my circus.
Why did you do this?
Listen, Nikita, you're an old cooper. They're waiting for you. Whatever else happens, you can't let them down.
Why did you do this?
Nikita, I can't help it. I love him.
Lida. Lida, it isn't true. Lida, it's not true.
Thank you.
And gentlemen, for 40 years I have been your servant. Have I ever broken faith with you?
No!
Has Nikita ever disappointed you? Many tragedies occur in the lives of us of the circus out there, in our private lives, of which you know nothing. I'm not going to plead for Nikita, but I ask you, if you are sportswomen, if you are sportsmen, you will give Nikita a chance to continue. Yes?
Yes!